Benedict XVI just celebrated the anniversary of his ordination. It was June 29, 1951. Ratzinger was only 24 years old. Since then, 60 years have passed. He's now the Pope and a bishop. But above all, he's a priest, which is manifested in his daily work.
During personal meetings we held when I was the Vatican's Deputy Secretary of State, I felt his extraordinary priestly humanity. That trait is typical of someone who loves the priesthood. He would always thank me for work I had done or for work that was being done. When I would talk to him about an ill person, he would remember and ask me about it during our next meeting, even if weeks had passed. He showed concern for all the people I told him about.
Archbishop Fernando Filoni is one of the close collaborators of the Pope. As a Deputy Secretary of State, for 4 years he was responsible for all sorts of ordinary business management within the Church. He went along with the Pope on his travels and also served as a link for the Vatican Curia. Now as Prefect of the Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples, the so-called Mission Territories, which account for almost a third of the dioceses of the world, depend on him.
Lui per tutta la vita.
Jesus Christ has interested the Pope throughout his life. I would say the pinnacle of this is in his book, Jesus of Nazareth. It's the fruit of his meditation, his thought, his writings and teachings throughout his 60 years of priesthood.
By coincidence, Archbishop Filoni has just celebrated his ordination anniversary. That was 41 years ago, on July 3, 1970.
It helps many of us to remember the day of our ordination. It's important for priests to keep it in our memory. Personally, I always, in any event, feel and have felt the need to return to the beginning of my priestly life and to recall that time. It's something we should not forget.
It's a similar message to that of Benedict XVI, who defined his ordination as the beginning of a deep personal friendship with God.